My name is Elliot Erwitt, and my profession is taking pictures. I started taking pictures early in the game, you might say. I got a plate camera when I was 14, 15 years old and started taking pictures with it. My first job as a photographer was to take pictures of my neighbors, my dentist, just anybody. Some years after my experimenting with photography in Los Angeles, I assembled a portfolio of pictures and decided to move to New York and see if I could start a career. That's how I met Edward Steichen and Roy Stryker. Pittsburgh was, at that time, redoing the center of the city, the Point, so-called, demolishing the entire area to rebuild a modern city. And this documentation was the job given to Roy Stryker, who hired photographers to take pictures of the process, including me. I was allowed to take photographs without any specific assignment, just street photography. It was my great chance. One of my best pictures, I think, is one that I took early in my career. It's of a little black boy with a gun to his head, a toy gun, I assure you. It's a picture that I think is one of my best pictures because of what it says and what it doesn't say, mostly what it doesn't say. If it has some kind of magic, you don't have to explain it. This picture says that to me. It says to me about the condition of the time and perhaps even now. I was working on this project for a few months, but then I got hired by the United States government, the Army that is. I left after 4 months, leaving my negatives in Pittsburgh. These negatives have been sitting in, had been sitting in the Carnegie Library for all this time, since 1954 or so. And they were discovered by Vaughn Wallace, a Pittsburgher, who brought these to my attention. We decided that it was pretty good stuff, so we made a book out of it. And this became this current book and exhibition. And that's the story of Pittsburgh 1950.